Okay, so welcome to this interview. We are talking with Chris Chu, who is one of the Udacity engineers, and he's been working on App Engine. And we're going to talk a little bit today about how Udacity uses App Engine in production and some of the things that are different from writing toy apps. You know, we've been writing these simple things, and Udacity actually has thousands of users, and so it's a much different problem that they're solving. So we spoke before about how when you came to Udacity, you were skeptical about App Engine, and you expected to try to have to convert people. And how has your experience been so far?
Yeah, actually, it's been interesting. I think a lot of people, especially the more engineering experience you have, the more skeptical you tend to be about something that makes claims as big as App Engine's claims. And you know, everything always has trade-offs, and App Engine has trade-offs. But you know, I really did come to Udacity thinking that I would be able to talk everybody out of moving to something different, where we'd have a little bit more control. And I think the opposite has actually happened. I've been a little converted the other way, and I think you know, App Engine's really the perfect spot for Udacity, and Udacity really does run on App Engine. We really do have a lot of traffic, and there's even some larger websites that have way more traffic than we do that run successfully on App Engine.
Okay, actually, so I had the same thought. You know, we decided to use App Engine because you know, I thought it would be easy to get up and online for students so they wouldn't have to do sysadmin things. But you know, I've always done my own thing as well, not used App Engine, so I was highly skeptical, and I've had a similar change of heart. So what are some of the things that App Engine does that make it so nice to work in that you would otherwise have to do on your own?
The big one, it always boils down to they provide a lot of infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Caching, highly replicated data stores. They force you to address what consistency means in your application. Does a name have to be updated everywhere immediately, or can things be a little bit slower to update? You know, things like that, that building a simple app, you don't have to think, and then all of a sudden you get really big, and then you have to scramble to try and redefine, you know, how those sorts of things are going to work in your system. The queuing is actually really powerful. It's really smooth. It seems very reliable, and you know, allows you to build, you know, tasks and really focus on the tasks as opposed to the infrastructure to get the tasks delivered. The login infrastructure, by and large, works actually really well. Works really well considering the scale of logging statements you can put through it.
You mentioned the queuing, which is funny because we actually just spent a lot of time in the previous interview with Neil from Reddit talking about all of the infrastructure Reddit has built around the queues and the pre-computing cache and that sort of stuff was actually really tough for us to build. And there's a lot of things that I think were really tough for us to build. I wonder if you can mention, talk a little bit about how the version handling works in App Engine and how that kind of fits into the bigger picture.
Versions are actually really interesting in App Engine. They're different than what I expected. And so they actually allow you to upload a totally different code base, really, but going against the same data store and the same services. And you can use that, I guess, in a couple of different ways effectively. One thing is that it enables what we call A/B testing. So kind of like two versions of a site are running at the same time. And there's actually an A/B testing, some administration there that allows you to kind of blend, you know, percentage of users in a somewhat sticky manner so that, you know, you can roll out new features to some users and test them. And as they're more successful, migrate all the users to the new features, things like that. The other thing is that they kind of provide you a way to have, I think of it as like aspects into a system. You can actually, you know, you could have a version of an app that is for mainly administrative tasks, or for purely testing, or for monitoring, and then what, you know, your normal users would see in the site, and they're all running simultaneously, and you know, against the same, you know, data store and services. But it allows you to kind of, you know, partition your logic, and so you could still reuse models and things between them. And it was a surprising feature that in there, and it seems to be really handy.
Cool.